Hi everyone, subscribe our TP studies and also click on the bell icon to get new updates. Never miss an opportunity to learn from our Turning Point. And thanking for subscribers and new viewers can subscribe our channel. So friends, today we are there with one word substitutions which are very important for your bank as well as for central government exams. So in previous class, we learned with a 10 one-word substitutions. Are you a tetoetler? So tetoetler is nothing but one who avoids alcohol. So we learned with some 10 one-word substitutions in previous class. In today's class, we learn another 10 one-word substitutions. Manamu previous class la 10 one-word substitution nerchukunnamandi. Ee roju 10 we will learn. So firstly we have polyglot. So polyglot means a polyglot woman. So I will provide you with a sentence like this. You have to guess the meaning now. Polyglot. You know the root word poly. Poly means many. Polyglot. Guess the meaning for this, friends. So poly means many, glot means one who knows many languages is called polyglot. A polyglot woman is nothing but a woman who knows many languages. It's more than 3 languages, maybe Kannada, English, Hindi, Tamil, Telugu, like this kind of languages, more languages if she knows, if one knows that. That person we can describe a polyglot, which means one who knows many languages, one who knows many languages. So next we have congregation. So let me give you with an example. Singing a song by a congregation. Singing by congregation. What does it mean by congregation? So here I told polyglot woman. Polyglot means one who knows many languages. So chala languages telusunte vallini polyglot antarandi. Congregation is nothing but a group of people who are present in church or a temple. So worshippers, a group of worshippers together is called congregation. So there are a lot of words like this for a group of. So group of people who are watching TV, they are called viewers. And a group of rowdy peoples. So rowdy gang unte dani rabble ani antarandi, very important. Rabble, which means a group of rowdies, is called rabble. Next, a group of people who are attending funeral. Funeral ceremony never attend out under only mourners and enter. So these words are related to a group of. Very important. Congregation means a group of worshippers, which means a group of worshippers who are present in temple or a church. They are called congregation. Next, a group of rowdies is called rabble. A group of people who are attending a funeral ceremony is called mourners. So clear with this, right? Singing by a congregation means singing a song by congregation. Group of worshippers are singing one song. So in place, either it may be a temple or a church. So some sacred place. There we will call as congregation. So a group of people at church or temple. A group of people at church or temple is called congregation. Group of rowdies is called rabble, friends. Next, a group of people who are attending funeral are called mourners. Mourn means sad and sad. So mourners, they will feel, so if anyone dies, we will feel happy now or sad. Of course we will sad. We will feel sad. So that is called mourners. Next we have lecturers. So in previous class, as I told about dexterous. Dexter means a root word, which means a right hand, which means a skillful person is called a dexterous, I told. So dexterous is nothing but a dexterous batsman, a dexterous keyboard player. So guess the meaning for this. Dexterous. So in exam also they will give like this only, friends. They will give one sentence and they will guess, tell the meaning to guess according to the context. You have to guess. So by reading this sentence you have to guess the meaning. A dexterous batsman, which means whether it give you a positive sense or a negative sense. Just analyze that first, just get an idea about it. A dexterous batsman, so maybe it gives a positive sense. If you feel so, what is that positive word? So think about the root word. Dexter means a right hand, I told, which means it indicates a positive sense. So dexterous is nothing but a skillful person is called dexterous. Our synonym, I told, dryad. So dexterous is nothing but a skillful person. It's called dexterous. Next. Posthumous child. So you might have had posthumous book. So after the death of a person, if a book released is called posthumous book. Here posthumous child. So a posthumous child will suffer a lot in future. What does it mean? So posthumous child ante ibbudu evarana parents after death of his father or mother, if a child born, that child is called posthumous child. So think it's a delivery time, at that time mom, mother has gone. So only baby is survived. So that baby is called a posthumous child. So delivery time la mummy chachipoyi malla papa emana migilunte dani posthumous child ani antarandi. A child born after the death of his father or mother. After the death of his father or mother. He is called posthumous child. So next related to this, we have a waif. What does it mean? Orphan means, you know, a child who don't have parents called orphan. Next, a wife. What does it mean? So a homeless person who don't have a shelter, for them we will use this word, a wife. So a homeless person is called wife. So posthumous child means a child born after the death of his father or mother. Next, polyglot. A polyglot woman, which means a woman who knows many languages. Congregation, singing by congregation, singing by group of people who are in church or temple, congregation. Dexterous, dexterous batsman, which means skillful batsman. So posthumous child, born after his death of his dad or mom, is called posthumous child. So while talking also you kindly use this kind of words like polyglot, you are dexterous, like that, so that your vocabulary will improve day by day. Next we have fanatic. Just use sentences like this, a dexterous batsman, a polyglot woman. Next, fanatic, you are a fanatic. Fanatic, religious fanatics, you might have heard. Religious fanatics, what does it mean? So fanatic is nothing but enthusiastic towards sacred things. So evarikaithe chaala expressive enthusiastic untundo devur paina vaalni fanatic ani antarandi. So we strongly enthusiastic or expressive towards sacred things is called fanatic. Religious views gurinchi evarikaithe chaala abhimanam untundi enthusiastic ga untaru vaalni fanatic ani antarandi. So enthusiastic towards religious views is called fanatic. Very important word. A enthusiastic towards religious views. He is called fanatic. Next we have lunatic. Are you a lunatic? What does it mean, lunatic? I think you have gone lunatic. Fanatic means enthusiastic towards religious views. One who loves sacred things, or one who is expressive or enthusiastic towards religious views is called fanatic. Important word. You are fanatic means you are religious views. You have a enthusiasm towards religious views. దాన్ని ఫెనాటిక్ అని అంటారండి. పవిత్రం గురించి, దేవుడి గురించి ఎవరికైతే అభిమానం ఉంటుందో వాళ్ళని ఫెనాటిక్. ఎవరు డాడీ మమ్మీ చచ్చిపోయింటారు మళ్ళా పుట్టింటే దాన్ని పోస్ట్ థామస్ చైల్డ్. నెక్స్ట్ డెక్స్టరస్. ఏ డెక్స్టరస్ బ్యాట్స్మ్యాన్ మీన్స్ ఎ స్కిల్ఫుల్ బ్యాట్స్మ్యాన్. డెక్స్టరస్ మీన్స్ స్కిల్ఫుల్. కాంగ్రిగేషన్ అంటే వర్షిపర్స్. చర్చెస్ ఆర్ టెంపుల్. ఇఫ్ ద వర్షిపర్స్ ఆర్ ప్రజెంట్ ఎ గ్రూప్ ఆఫ్ వర్షిపర్స్ ఇస్ కాల్డ్ కాంగ్రిగేషన్. నెక్స్ట్ పాలిగ్లాట్. ఎ పాలిగ్లాట్ ఉమెన్. What does it mean? So, ఎవరికైతే మోర్ దాన్ 3 లాంగ్వేజెస్, మెనీ లాంగ్వేజెస్ తెలిసింటే వాళ్ళని పాలిగ్లాట్. నెక్స్ట్ వీ హ్యావ్ లునాటిక్. ఆర్ యూ ఏ లునాటిక్ అని యూస్ చేస్తారండి. వాట్ డస్ ఇట్ మీన్? సో లునాటిక్ ఈజ్ నథింగ్ బట్ మెంటలీ ఇల్. ఫర్ మెంటల్స్ వీ విల్ యూజ్ దిస్ వర్డ్ లునాటిక్. వన్ హూ ఈజ్ మెంటలీ ఇల్. సో మెంటలీ ఫీ ఈజ్ ఇల్ వీ విల్ యూజ్ లునాటిక్. లునాటిక్ ఈజ్ నథింగ్ బట్ మెంటలీ ఇల్. Fanatic is nothing but enthusiastic towards religious views. Fanatic, lunatic, you remember. This is about religious views. Religious fanatics are used as surrounding. Which means religious views. Enthusiastic. Next, lunatic is nothing but a mental or a mentally ill person is called lunatic. Next, we have blasphemy. Very important. Fanatic and blasphemy as per your exams. So, blasphemy is nothing but one who is disrespectful towards God. Or one who scolds God is called blasphemy. So disrespectful or one who scolds God is called blasphemy. ఎవరైతే గాడ్ని అపవిత్రంగా మాట్లాడతారో, ఎవరైతే తిట్టారో గాడ్ని, వాళ్ళని blasphemy అంటారు ఆ ప్రాసెస్ని. సో blasphemer. Blasphemy means disrespectful towards God. Blasphemer is a person who is disrespectful towards God or who scolds God. For a particular person we will use blasphemer. So for the kind of habit we will use blasphemy, disrespectful towards God. Blasphemy activities should be strictly maintained, should be strictly avoided, which means disrespectful towards God, scoldings towards God should be maintained, should be avoided any meaning. So it's nothing but disrespectful towards God. So, know the difference between fanatic and blasphemy. Blasphemy is disrespectful towards God. Fanatic is nothing but enthusiastic towards religious views. Just opposite, slightly opposite. Next, we have cynic. So, you might have seen lawyers. They will ask many questions for the criminal who was standing in your court. So, a lot of questions if he is asking, which means he is a doubtful person. For a doubtful person, we will use the word cynic. Cynic is nothing but a doubtful person. Cynics were stopped when the factories opened. So what does it mean? Cynics, which means a doubtful person, stopped talking, stopped arguing when the factories opened. So cynic is nothing but a doubtful person. A person who asks questions frequently is called a cynic or skeptical. Skeptical means also a doubtful person. Next we have amulet. So let me say one example so that you guess the meaning for this sentence. So CM of Andhra Pradesh visited 20 amulets a previous week. What does it mean? He visited 20 amulets. What do you mean by amulet? So friends, hamlet is nothing but a smaller community of people less than a village. So in village there will be some 50 or 100 homes nearly. So in this case of hamlet there will be a less than village, which means some 10 houses like that, 10 homes if there is, that is called hamlet. So a community of people less than village is called hamlet. It's called hamlet. So CM visited hamlet means CM visited small community places which is less than villages. Next we have extreme poor. Extreme poor is nothing but there is some function going, let me think, some Republic Day is going on. So that your teacher will tell you to speak some words. So you go and you will give speech and you will come back. So without preparation if you give a speech, that public speech is called extreme poor. So if without preparation what you did, you delivered the speech. So that speech is called extreme poor. A speech without preparation is called extreme poor. An extreme poor public speech. What does it mean? A public speech without a preparation is called extreme poor speech. A speech without preparation. So these are the 10 words we learned today. Polyglot. Are you a polyglot? So do you know many languages? If you should say yes. If you don't know, you should say no. So like this, you have to use the sentences while talking also. Are you a polyglot? Yes, good. Next, polyglot. A polyglot woman is nothing but a polyglot means one who knows many languages. Congregation. Group of people present at church or temple is called congregation. So rabble ani cheppanu. Rabble means rowdy's group is called rabble. Mourners means this all related to a group of. Mourners is nothing but a group of people attending funeral ceremony. They are called mourners. Next, we learnt about dexterous. In root words also I told about dexterous. Dexter means dexter indicates right hand, whereas sinister indicates left hand. Dexter gives you a positive meaning, sinister gives you a negative meaning. So dexterous is nothing but a skillful person. So a dexterous keyboard player, which means a skillful keyboard player, a dexterous batsman, a skillful batsman, that is called dexterous, no doubt. Next, posthumous child. A child born after a death of his father or mother is called posthumous child. So after his death of parent, if the child is born, that is called posthumous child. So posthumous, you might have heard posthumous book. After the death of some person, if the book's published, that is called posthumous book. So this kind of root words are very important. Next, fanatic, lunatic, I told. Fanatic means enthusiastic towards religious views. Lunatic, mentally ill. Just opposite to fanatic, important word, blasphemy. Disrespectful towards God. Blasphemy activities should be avoided, should be prohibited. Cynic. Cynic means doubtful. One who asks frequent questions is called cynic. Are you a cynic? Yes. Next, hamlet. CM of Andhra Pradesh visited hamlets, which means smaller communities, less than village is called hamlet. Next, extreme poor. A speech, extreme poor public speech. A speech delivered without preparation is called extreme poor. So this is about a 10 one word substitution in today's class. We learn with the another 10 words in next class. Thank you for watching the video. Have a nice day.